Look, I've made it no secret I want to be in the front line, so I guess that puts two positions out there. But so 10-12. But in saying that as well, like, you never know what's going to happen with the team, and it's pretty competitive in this back line, so I guess whatever opens up is I'm going to take. So I'm putting my hand up for those positions, so that's where I've been training the last couple of days there anyway. But yeah, whatever's best for the team, as always, I'm happy to put on a jersey and just want to be starting.
With playing number 10 with the Wallabies, does that sort of really reinforce that that's where you want your future to be in rugby?
Yeah, well, I enjoy touching the ball as much as possible. So whether it's 10 or 12, they're the two positions, I guess, that control the team around the field and get the most touches. So that says in itself.
Obviously, early days, James, but just your early initial thoughts of the club, the group, how much talent's in the squad?
Yeah, there's a lot of talent running around the team. There's no doubt about that. That's sort of attracted me here. I guess there's only a little bit of fine-tuning needed. And after, I guess, we've recruited a guy like Kirtleyville as well, who can make something from nothing. It's pretty exciting. But not only that, I guess, coming down here, just the whole club culture is pretty amazing, I guess. I've spent four and a half years playing professional rugby, and I haven't seen anything sort of like this yet. So I'm excited to see how we go.
It's obviously a long way back after last season, only winning three games. So what's sort of a realistic expectation for the season ahead?
Well, I guess, look, it's still early days. As the boys were saying, look, there's a lot of competitive guys in this team that I don't like to lose. So I guess after last year, the guys, I guess, want to get as many wins as possible. But you don't really want to put a number on it as we just started pre-season and whatnot. But I think it's fair to say we're going to be as competitive as we can. And if the links and the combinations come off well, it should be a force to be reckoned with.
Do you feel the better expectation? I mean, like, Kirtley and you are just kind of the biggest expectation out of the team this year. I mean, you've handled it before, obviously, but, I mean, were you about to feel that down here?
Yeah, look, it comes with the territory. I wouldn't say it's nothing I haven't experienced before. I play rugby because I love to play it, and I guess for me personally, I do it because I enjoy it, and because I enjoy, I guess, the company of my teammates, and I guess the whole vibe of the members and the fans, etc. So for me, I'm just coming down here. I'm already enjoying it, but I just want to, I guess, play some good rugby. And the brand of rugby that I've seen already today, if you watch training, you would see it's pretty. It's like nothing sort of I've been a part of.
During the recruitment process, did the Rebels mention 10 and 12 to you? I mean, was that a bit of enticement?
I guess that's sort of what I've been mentioning. I've been thrown out there a lot the last couple of years. That's where I want to be playing. So, yeah, look, that's been thrown out there, but I guess in saying that, it's been said for quite a while.
What's your best
rival
for number 10, Danny Cipriani?
Oh, you're killing my rival. He's my teammate. But Danny's a good mate of mine, and I think in this team, I can see myself playing 12 pretty nicely, and with Danny signing into 10. So I wouldn't really call him a rival. We're going to be playing on the same team, and hopefully we can build something pretty special. There's no doubt he's a talent. I think he could be should be the number 10 for England. So you never know what's going to be happening there. Yeah. Well, you can ask him about that one, but yeah, I'll be kicking. We'll see. Whoever's the best kicker will be getting the job. So there's going to be a lot of competition, as for positions as well.